Okay. So, hello everyone. So, I'm Jean-Baptiste and Geoffroy is here. So, we are at the software development department from RTE. And RTE, was it RTE? So, we will give some elements of context. So, RTE is the French TSO, so transmission system operator. We handle from 20 kV to 400 kV, so it's the high voltage. And we must provide electricity 24/7 for all the customers and all the inhabitants in France and, of course, in Europe, because we have to cooperate. And the particularity is that we have we are asset owner of the grid, which means that we are responsible to invest and make sure that the equipment will be okay to work to complete our mission as a TSO. And we are also responsible to adapt the structure to make sure that we will ease the transition energy. So we create some interconnections, and we also try to adapt the grid to connect, for example, offshore wind generators. So we have many, many challenges in a fast-changing world. So we have, of course, a new energy mix with a big goal around neutral carbon neutrality for 2050. So it's a big challenge, and we have also some codes, some regulation that make drastic change, and we must adapt to that. So it's a whole package where we have a lot of work to do at RTE and in Europe. And for that, I will read the sentence because it's very important. So today, okay. So today's need is very important to understand is that today's need is not to build a tool that answers present need, but to build a tool that is capable to integrate quickly and efficiently tomorrow's need. And if you have the idea of the tender to create the way to create new tools, sometimes you make specification, then you make the tender process, then you ask a vendor to develop, and this cycle is maybe like 4 years. The problem is that we don't know what we will be asked to do in five years, because everything is changing very fast. So what is the strategy for it to answer those issues is to use open source. And Geoffroy will present you two tools that are based on open source. So Possible, which is one of the first projects that was started the Linux Foundation Energy Initiative, and then what we can do, what you can build on top of Possible. So I'll let the floor to Geoffroy to present in detail the tools.
So hello everyone. So the first project, Possible. So Possible, it means power system blocks. Blocks, so this is a software component that we have as a foundation of many other applications, especially at RTE. So we have something like 15 projects that are based on, as a list, a few components that has been developed in Possible. So what is the content of Possible? What is it? So this is many things, but it's first a way to model the power grid. So we have a data model that allows us to have a grid model and to use it to make, for example, some evolutions, so change for this grid model, and to study what will be the impact. We also have some component for visualization of the grid that will be integrated in some higher level application. Also, what is very important is to be able to feed this data model with some data. So for that, we have some converter coming and to standard data format. So the most used one and the most famous one is SIM, the SIM data model. So we have premium support for SIM converter, SIM data model support. And also what is very important is to have some interoperability with a commercial tool. For example, the one there's two very widely used commercial tools, which are the PSCC from Siemens and also Power Factory. So we are able to import some data into our data model from these tools. And also, we also have some converter from academic data format, for example, MatPower, which is very widely used for research and science. And with this data model, we are able to run some analysis functions, for example, powerful calculation, security analysis. So security analysis, for example, this is a nice function that allows to test what will be the impact of some contingency. For example, the, we have a line loss, an outage on the grid, and we want to see what is really the impact of this outage on the flow, on the voltage, to see if we have some trouble. We also have some scientific analysis, short-term calculation, which is also very important, and also dynamic simulation, so time domain simulation. This is why we are integrated with another project of the Linux Foundation Energy, which is Dynawo. So this is mostly written in Java. And this is this has been designed to be as light as possible. So there is no dependency with a complex framework or anything that take decision to what how do you are going to use it in a higher level application. So GridSuite. GridSuite is an example of a tool that is built on top of the component of Possible. And that allow people to make some grid study. And very different studies. So it starts from a real-time study, for example, security analysis, to a long-term development study. For example, we can, with this tool, study what will be the impact of a connection of a new, new renewable generation power plant on the grid, and to assess that everything is fine if we connect this generation in a specific place on the grid. So this is a tool that is that has been moved into production very recently. So at the end of last year, so since a few weeks, and we still have some very early users. And what we plan to have is 400 users in the coming 2 years. And so this tool will replace an existing tool, which is at RT since something like 15 years. So we have a team of more than 20 developers, and it is a growing team. From the technical part, the technical stack that we are using is for sure 100% open source. So this is a microservice-based application, very scalable application. Based on Java, Spring Boot, we have everything is based on REST API and also asynchronous messaging with RabbitMQ. On the storage part, is most of the microservices are based on PostgreSQL and Elasticsearch. As it's quite difficult to manage such a distributed application with a lot of microservices, we have everything is deployed using a Kubernetes cluster. And on the front-end part, so this is with the web application using React.js, and also we use a little bit of WebGL for high performance representation of the grid. So an important issue that we had with this is that we have some Java component, which is very convenient to integrate it into, I would say, a classical enterprise application, where often the backend is made of, is based on the Java ecosystem with Spring, Quarkus, or this kind of framework. So this is fine, but what we had is also needed to use this component also for research and data science community. And most of the people from the data science communities are on the Python ecosystem. So the question was for us how to use the same piece of code in these two ecosystems and how to use it, how to share the code for in Python and Java. So what we have done is to use another fantastic open source tool, which is GraalVM. And GraalVM, this is done by Oracle. And this is several things, but we are using a component with native image that allow to compile Java code into a native code. And thanks to this, we are able to build a C library for everything that we have in possible. And with this library, we can build a classical Python extension module based on the C library. Okay. So some useful links. So for sure, there is a GitHub repository for both project possible and GridSuite. Maybe I can focus on the Slack channels, the two Slack channels. So this is really the place where we answer questions and we discuss with the community. Also, there is an online demo of the application GridSuite. So if you want to test it, you can do it. So we have an instance of GridSuite that is deployed in the cloud, and you can connect to this one just using your, for example, your GitHub account. Also, there is a YouTube video if you want to show a live demo. So this is a screenshot of the application. What you can see here, just to explain what is it. So on the left side, we have the data manager. So starting from a case, from an initial grid model, we have a way to create a tree of variant of modification that allows us to test different changes in the network. And for all these variants, we can run some calculations, some analysis, and then compare what is the best and what is the best one for us. Then you can see on the right side that we have some way to represent, to display the grid. So this is a full representation of the French high voltage grid. We have also some substation diagram, like here. We have some what we call the network radiogram, which is part of the grid that is shown in a nodal view. And then we can run some calculation. We also have some table to see the data in a tabular form. We have some specific user interface to show the result, etc., etc. So this is the end for the presentation. If you have any question, or if you want a demo of this tool, we can do it after the presentation. If you want, if you are interested to have a more detailed view of this tool.
I was just wondering what format your network data is in, and whether you can, whether you could, for example, take in the OpenStreetMap network data and try analysis on it. It's not complete, but can we do that?
So this is not OpenStreetMap. This is Mapbox, but we can change the type provider to use whatever we want. So here we have used a very light tile representation, representation of the grid, just to have a better view of the grid. But we can you can use if we want OpenStreetMap. Yeah.
How do you make the link between the grid and the end consumption items or human on the grid? Meaning, do you go to machine to machine communication system so that the people stop consuming, or do you make advanced polls in order to know the consumptions within 1 hour, within 1 month?
So this tool is based off a snapshot of the grid. So this is done by some other tool which are before this one. So we have the SCADA, for example, which are doing the acquisition of the measurement, and that has the database of the grid model. And from this, we have some snapshot, and then it can go into this tool. Okay? I don't know if I answer the question.
How do you handle the stress when, for example, the grid is
hands up. Okay. Wait, so we will answer the question later.